Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So today we got a big update, which is we got two new characters added to the game, and the one that we can gacha right now is Cocoa. Yeah, the other new character is Soda, but she will be added later. And look at that. That's something like massively oversized. It's like defying gravity. Wow, okay. So anyway, let's look at Cocoa, the one that we can pull today. So she's a character number one, and then she's a support, a sniper rifle character. Not my favorite type of weapon, to be honest. And she is a healer. Affect all allies, recovers 17% of Coffer's HP as HP, and affect two ally units with debuff randomly, dispels one debuff. So she can remove debuff, she can also heal. Seems like a pretty good character. Yeah, a pretty good healer. And the skill 2 activates when attacking with full charge effect self. Sustained damage reduced 4.37%, stack up to 15 times, and lasts for 5 seconds. 15 times, really? So in total, we can get 65% damage reduction. Woo! But yeah, it will only affect herself, so she is kind of like a tanky healer. Seems like an interesting skill set. And the ultimate, affect all allies, dispel one debuff. You know, this debuff thing, usually, if the enemy actually use it, especially the bosses, like stun, for example, usually all of our characters getting stunned at the same time. So I don't think this is going to be useful against bosses that usually stun the whole party at the same time, but I think this will be quite useful for some stages that have, you know, certain enemy can do chain and stuff that simply lock one character. I think this could be useful, as long as she is not the one that is getting debuffed. And the other skill is activates when professional tomato sauce is fully stacked. Affect all enemies. Attack down, minus 13.59% for 10 seconds. Attack down, okay. Yeah, the healing part doesn't seem to be reliable, to be honest. The cooldown is 15 seconds and only recovers 17% of Coffer's HP as HP. Okay, I'm not really sure about this, but yeah, maybe once I got her and use her, maybe I will know. Yeah, now about Soda, the oversized lady. She is also a healer, character number one, support, and she is a machine gun character. A much better weapon type in my opinion rather than sniper rifle, to be honest. So activates after 180 normal attacks affect self. Mid spirit max HP plus 13%, stack up to 5 times and last for 10 seconds. Okay, max HP boost. Only for herself. Selfish skill. The second skill, affect all allies, recovers HP by 3.23% of caster's max HP. Just how low is that? And the cooldown is 12 seconds. I don't think this is going to be reliable at all. Now the second part. Activates when mage spirit is fully stacked. Affect all allies. Recovers HP by 12.71% of caster's max HP. This one is better, but why only 12% though? They could have made it 20% or 25%, but yeah, only 12%. And the cooldown is 12 seconds, really. The ultimate. Cooldown 20 seconds. Affect two enemy units randomly. Deals damage, okay, and stun enemy for 1 second. Only 1 second, okay. But this could interrupt the enemy's ultimate if you use it in the arena. And the second part is affect all allies with fire element. Stack count of buffs plus 1. This one could be useful. It's kinda like forcing you to build a mono fire character just for this. Well, looks like a not bad healer, but not something that is super OP in my opinion. Yeah, just a not bad healer. You can use her if you got her. And Cocoa's ultimate cooldown is also 20 seconds. Yeah, I forgot to mention this. So yeah, two new healers. And the other cool update today, which is the coolest update, is new item, spare body selection box. Okay, so after the February 1st update, a new challenge upgrade Nikke's to level 141 for the first time has been added. Basically, what we can get from this is this item. So we can get one SSR spare body for free, which we can use to limit break our characters to limit break 3. So thank you so much for shift up for this item. Yeah, because this is actually really really important for FTP. Because by far I only have one character with limit break 3, which is my Julia, and I got her on my previous video. And yeah, I still have a lot of characters that need to be limit break 3 so that I can raise all of my characters into level 200 with the synchronized device function. So by far I already have Frima, Atmi, Signal as my limit break 2 characters. This is interesting because if I use that selection box, I will be able to get one more limit break 3 characters, right? And if I use my Silver Mile HC Cat, I think I will get one more limit break 3 characters. So I only need to get two more limit break 3 characters. And my Silver Mile H is currently 360. So if I do 40 more pulls, I will be able to get one more SSR body levels from the mileage shop. And that's going to be my fourth limit break 3 characters. And my gold mileage ticket is now 300, so it means I still have to do 100 more pulls so that I can get two SSR characters, I mean the new SSR characters. And that also means I have to get the character, and then if I use those two gold mileage ticket, and then once the new character become regular character, which we can get from the ordinary recruit, I think I will be able to get that character to limit break 3 easier. To be honest, I'm kinda a little bit guilty if I don't pull here on the ordinary recruit, because I already set my wishlist as the characters that I already have, and some of them already limit break 1 or 2, which is going to give me faster limit break 3 because I'm FTP, okay? But since we got the new character Cocoa, I think, okay, just for this video, I will try, let's say, 20 pulls. Yeah, and then I think I can spend the rest here. Who knows, I will be able to get limit break 3 characters. Wait, what about Soda? Well, let's see about that. I think I will be able to get 10 more tickets for Soda later. So let's try, 20 pulls. Who knows, I will be able to get Cocoa. Yeah, the first pull. Let's go. Well, if I able to get her, I think, yeah, somehow I still able to use her. Later, once I got all limit break 3 characters and make her level 200 with the synchronized device, which is kinda like still far from now. Okay, hopefully yellow. Yellow! Yellow! Yeah, I know, right? I still can get yellow from this new character's banner. But if you look at here on the Nikkepedia, I actually have around 16 characters that I don't have yet. So the chance to get limit break is kinda quite harder compared to do it on the ordinary recruit, to be honest. So yeah, let's do it once again here and spend the rest on the ordinary recruit banner. Hopefully Cocoa or SSR that I already have and already limit break 1 or 2. Please. Yellow, please. Yeah. Hello. Okay. So I got 20 gold mileage ticket. Okay. Now let's spend the ticket. 10 ordinary recruit summon ticket. Hopefully SSR here. Okay, my last pull here on the ordinary recruit got me Julia, which lead my Julia to limit break 3. So hopefully this time another limit break 3 character, please. Yeah, oh nice. Limit break punch. Come on. Double yellow. Okay, only one. One is already good enough though. But who knows, double yellow or triple yellows, right? Elysian. Ooh. I think limit break 1 or 2. I forgot. Let's see. She's limit break 2 now. Holy moly. Alrighty. So nice, now I have 4 limit break 2 characters already. Cool, let's keep doing this, ordinary recruit. ordinary. Come on, limit break again. SSR, please. I think I'm getting closer to that all limit break 3 characters party. Yellow again. I think it is a good decision for me to spend my gems on ordinary recruit. So that's it. Limit break punch! Double yellow? Only one, okay. Please, please, please. The one that is going to give me limit break 3. Listen. Elm again? Oh. Brit? Limit break, definitely, but I think... Wait. Let's see. Oh, okay. Limit break 1. Well, not bad. Well, who knows? I will keep getting Brit over and over after this. Okay, one last pull on the ordinary recruit. Yeah, this wishlist is actually really, really helpful. So that's it. My last 3,000 gems. Go! Limit break, please. Yellow again, please. 3 in a row, please. Yellow! Punch! Ah. But that's already really nice. 30 pulls on the ordinary recruit and I got 2 yellows. That's already a very, very lucky pulls. I think I can buy some body levels. 35. Can I open? Woohoo! I can open 1 gold mold. Let's do it. Hopefully another duplicate. 61% chance. Let's go. Boom. SSR. The loading is quite long. Okay, nice. Duplicate. Oh? New, okay. I don't have her yet. Well, I do have Epinel on my alt account. She's a not bad DPS. As FTP, maybe not getting the new character is just okay. At least until I will get all Limit Break 3 characters. Yeah. So that's all. Good luck for you guys. If you are trying to pull the new characters. So that's what I think about the new characters. Yeah, so thank you for watching. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe now if you haven't, and see you next time. Bye. Ushi Punch.